Roadrunner Rundown on Bakersfield.com and the CSUB Roadrunners Digital Network. Live from downtown Bakersfield, California.
Driving Harrington for the win! Yeah! CSUB Roadrunners are your Western Athletic Conference baseball champions!
Here's the voice of the runners, Corey Costello.
Welcome in once again to Roadrunner Rundown, the official program, CSUB Roadrunner Athletics. My name's Corey Costello, says so right there on the screen. Thanks so much for joining us. That's right, that's back. See, it keeps, wants to run away. There's back again. Welcome back to the program. Official program, CSUB Roadrunner Athletics. Got a great show for you today. Absolutely tremendous week of action for Roadrunner Athletics, and we're going to try to get to every bit of it. We couldn't cram it all into the highlights segment. We'll talk it through it about the throughout the show. We had basketball, men's and women's. We had baseball. We had softball. We had water polo. We had men's and women's swimming at the WAC championships. Five championships for women's swimming, including like five records as well. Two of those young ladies, Michaela Paige, who is an absolute, like, you want to talk about Kurt Schilling and the bloody sock incident. Michaela Paige literally won two championships with one arm the other day, which I don't know how you don't swim in a circle at that point, but she literally won it with one shoulder because she was in so much pain and so ineffective, but she still got it done. She's going to join us on the program. Dylana Milobar will join us as well. She was on her relay team that won a championship as well at the WAC championships in Houston. We'll talk with them on the program today. Men's basketball head coach Rod Barnes will join us. We will chat with him about a tremendous victory for Roadrunner basketball over Grand Canyon. We'll also be previewing Senior Day coming up this Saturday against Seattle. Also a short preview of the WAC tournament coming up. Runners locked in as the number two seed. They'll be taking on Chicago State next Thursday, 4:30 in Las Vegas at the Orleans Arena. And also on the program, our athletics director Ziggy Siegfried stopping by for a few minutes. We'll chat with him about, again, a jam-packed week and really a great time of year right now. Baseball's off to a phenomenal start. And so tons of stuff to get to on the program. And literally, we're just going to fly right through it today because we've got so much happening. Thanks so much for joining us on Bakersfield.com. Those of you also checking us out, Bakersfield On Demand through Bright House Networks, welcome to the program. Let's get right to the highlights because, like I said, I'm still talking. We've got a lot of stuff to get to. Men's basketball hosting Grand Canyon in homecoming in front of another packed house. And let's just talk about scoring. It was there all night. Shooting was there. There's Dedrick Basil with a three. How about Damian Durham knocking one of his five threes down? Another Basil baseline jumper. He had 19 points in the win for the Roadrunners. Damian Durham again, yes sir, let me pull up from the top of the arc and knock down a three. 15 for Basil, and then Basil once again hitting a three in the first half. Roadrunners were in control. They did get a little bit of action. The Grandy Glaze going for Grand Canyon. Runners, though, break the tie on the Kevin Mays jumper. CSUB then embarks on a 10-3 run at this point. Ali Ahmed hitting the mid-range jumper, and the runners start to take control later stages of the first half. Part of it was defense. Nice steal by Durham. Nice finish by Basil. He did it all in the ball game in front of a nearly packed house as well. Kevin Mays getting going. 21 points for Mays. He gets the lean off the glass underneath as well over Josh Braun. A good DeAndre Johnson, a good day for him. He led the way with Grand Canyon, the pull-up jumper. But again, still runners in the first half. More with Justin Hollins with the left-handed finish. Bakersfield got the post going. Kevin Mays, again, jump hook, tough angle off the window. Bakersfield starts to take the lead. Ali Ahmed going to get the miss. How about Kevin Mays? The offensive rebound and the putback. He had 21 points. My man had 10 rebounds as well. Dedrick Basil into the first half. The lean off the glass. Runners lead it at the break. And then second half action, more Kevin Mays. Mays, look at that. The miss. He's going to get his own rebound, go up, get fouled, and one. Count the bucket. Runners scored the first five of the half. They stretch their lead out to 16. Mays again, mid-range. Thank you, sir, as he goes from right to the top of the three-point line. And then Basil again, a steal, Jalen Arrington, the right-handed finish. Runner is starting to take it to Grand Canyon. They led this by as many as 18, due in part to 17 Grand Canyon turnovers. And then Durham, the dagger from way outside with about 15 minutes to play. This was all CSUB. Durham again is going to hit his second in the half. Every time Grand Canyon got something going, Durham had an answer. Matt Smith, how about the offensive rebound and the putback as well for CSUB? Long lead pass coming down here. Glaze is going to finish for Grand Canyon. They pulled within 10 at one point, but that would be about it because the runners just hit shots all night long. There's another one from Basil. He was the WAC player of the week. Brent Rapp going to go back on the outside. Kevin Mays, the pull-up jumper, he had 21 and 10, as I mentioned. A phenomenal game for Mays. And then once again, Basil driving, and Mays is going to finish with the flush. That's the punctuation mark on the ball game. An absolute drubbing for the runners. 77-52 over Grand Canyon. Kevin Mays, 21 points, 10 rebounds. Dedrick Basil, he had 19 points. He had 6 rebounds. He had 7 assists. And because of the complete effort, he was named WAC Player of the Week. A great win for the Roadrunners. Their first in the Division I era over Grand Canyon. This one wasn't even close, folks. Bakersfield all over them in that one. So the runners, after that win, let's take a look at their upcoming games. They've got one regular season game left. They will be taking on Seattle this Saturday night at 7 o'clock at the Icardo Center. Come on out and celebrate seniors Ali Ahmed and Kevin Mays on senior night. Final regular season home game for the runners. Before the WAC tournament coming up next week in Las Vegas, here's a look at the standings, and this is pretty much locked up. New Mexico State, the 1 seed. CSUB is the 2 seed. Grand Canyon not going to the tournament. Seattle is the 3 seed. Utah Valley is the 4 seed. Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and UMKC right now battling for the 5 and 6 seed, which means it really most likely both teams, if they UMKC wins and Utah and UTRGV loses, UMKC will win on the tiebreak, which will come down to RP. So they should be the 5 seed. Runners will see Chicago State in the first round at the WAC tournament next Thursday. So that's kind of where it stands for men's basketball. On to women's basketball. The ladies were on the road, and another phenomenal effort out of Badabe Zampari. 23 points, 13 rebounds. She hits 1,000 points and 1,000 rebounds for her career. She's only the 7th player active right now in NCAA Division I to do that. 76-67, the runners, big winners. They won their 2nd in a row, and it's important because let's look at the women's picture right now. By the way, they have one more game on the road at Seattle this Saturday at 2 o'clock. The runners will take on the Redhawks, and so here's the women's picture. Now, for as much as CSUB's been up and down this year, look where they're at. They are knocking on the door still of a potential 2 seed, so they still have a great shot. New Mexico State's the 1. Other than that, this thing is open. There's a lot of scenarios in play. So RGV, Utah Valley at 8-5, a game above Bakersfield. Runners there, though, at 7-6. They'll see Seattle. UMKC plays Chicago State this week. UTRGV plays New Mexico State, so a good shot that they'll lose that game. And then you've got Utah Valley and Grand Canyon meeting. Utah Valley loses. UTRGV loses. Runners could be right there. So it's a lot still to be decided on the ladies' side of things. So we'll have a complete bracket next week on the program, so it should be an interesting one for them as we head to CSUB baseball now. Roadrunners Sunday hosting St. John's at Hart Field as A.J. Menares pits in a good first 4 innings. How about this pickoff move? Gotcha. Leadoff single in the 5th for St. John's. Doesn't go anywhere, but then the Red Storm would get rolling a little bit. The ground ball to the right side, but David Metzger going to end the 5th on one of his 3 phenomenal plays in the hole, and then on to the 6th inning, but this is where St. John's would get going a little bit. 1-0 runners. St. John's, though, putting the tying run aboard. And then St. John's is going to not only tie the ball game as this one ground out of the third baseline, going to eat up Ryan Grotejohn a bit. So a run will score in this situation, at least put him in scoring position. And now St. John's, the opportunity to take the lead. The ground ball to the right side will tie things up here at 1 apiece, and the Red Storm and the runners are tied, but the Red Storm were not done. Single to the right side, that will score a run as St. John's will take the lead over CSUB to make it 2-1 here, and then St. John's in control of the game at 2-1, and then a sacrifice fly up to center field will make it 3-1 St. John's, so Bakersfield trailing in the late innings in the rubber match, by the way. This was the deciding game of the series. So 3-1 Red Storm, but the Roadrunners working away. Sergio Robles with the bunt here. That's going to move the runners up into scoring position. So now you've got the tying run at second base, and now you've got David Metzger at the plate. Metzger doing what Metzger does. He's going to single to the left side, and they're going to let the run score, but it's going to be a fielder's choice, and they're going to tag the runner out at third. So now the tying run's at first. Max Carter, where am I going to put it? Wherever they're not. Right in the gap. So guess what? The tying run is going to score from third base, as coming around to score is Robles on the play. Carter with the RBI double. We're tied at three. We're going to go to extra innings, folks, because why not? It's Sunday. We've played such great baseball, and now the runner's in the 11th inning. David Metzger at the plate. Winning run is at second base. Ball game. Metzger being Metzger, the RBI single. Roadrunners win it 4-3. A walk-off for David Metzger as the runners take the series over St. John's. 2-1 in some Sunday heroics. Here's head coach Bob Macaluso.
Well, you know, your goal is to win series. So we've won two series, so yes. And I like the way they're playing on Sunday. That's a good St. John's team, a solid team. We saw good pitching all weekend. And we played well, and well enough to win the series. I said, was there any doubt? And for me, no, and for them, same deal. He's, you know, if you have to pick a guy, not just around, you know, on West Coast, that's who you pick. Pick Metzger. I mean, he made great plays at second base. Chance made a great play in right field. And Dave's struggling a little bit at the plate, but he's still the guy you want up. They got a breaking ball up a little bit. He smashed it up the middle for the game winner, and we love it.
Yeah, that's pretty cool for my coach to say that about me. I mean, I'm undersized, so for him to say that, that's big for me. Yeah, our first series we went away. We were good playing away, and at home we kind of struggled last year a little bit. But I mean, we found a way to beat a good St. John's team here, and we're just going to continue to take that on to the rest of the season, and we're going to do great things.
So the runners take the winner-take-all finale on Sunday, 4-3 over St. John's. On Saturday, it was all Roadrunners as well, as Bakersfield got the 10-4 victory in the Saturday matchup. St. John's getting the Friday win as well, 5-4. So the runners needed that. Dustin Fraley, by the way, on Saturday. How about that? Four hits and an RBI triple as well. So the runners taking 2 out of 3 from St. John's. Here's what's coming up for Roadrunners baseball. They're going to be on the road this weekend. They're going to be at St. Mary's. Actually, it's at the University of Arizona tournament. St. Mary's going to play them twice, 2 o'clock on Friday and 2 o'clock on Saturday, Mountain Time. Saturday, they'll also see Arizona in the nightcap at 6 o'clock Mountain. Sunday, they'll also take on Northwestern State in the finale of that tournament on Sunday. So, CSUB baseball very busy. Roadrunners Wrestling Championships in the Pac-12 this past weekend. Bryce Hammond, congratulations, winning his third 174-pound championship in the Pac-12s with a victory. He's going to the NCAA Nationals. Ian Nickel finishes second at 141. He's on to the NCAA Nationals. Adam Fierro winning, getting second in 165. He's on to NCAA Nationals. Reuben Franklin finishing second in 187. Not confirmed yet, but Franklin with an RPI of 7 expected to get an at-large berth in the NCAA Nationals, so he is getting ready for Nationals as well. So most likely 4 wrestlers for Bakersfield. The final announcements will be made next week. Runners as a team, by the way, finished 3rd in the NCAA or in the Pac-12 championship. Finally, CSUB water polo, they were on the road as well. They go 4-0 at the Cal Lutheran tournament. Here are Sunday's results. They beat host Cal Lutheran 9-5 in the first match. Ashley Paz, Gabby Wiltz, East had 2 goals. Runners complete the weekend sweep with a 15-3 win over Siena. Ruby Versfeld with 3 goals in that win as well. Runners are at Azusa Pacific this weekend. All right, and like I said, there's just so much going on. Women's swimming and diving, 5 championships as well. We'll speak with Dylana Milobar, Michaela Page coming up on the program as well. We're late for a break. We got to talk to Coach Barnes. We'll talk men's basketball after their big win and their upcoming Seattle game Saturday and the WAC tournament. Back after this, it's Roadrunner Rundown.
What's up, big man?
I want to go faster.
Pedal harder.
Talking about our internet.
Okay, no problem.
I'm serious, dude.
Hey, I'm serious, too. We just increased your current internet speeds for free. Your Lightning internet just got faster.
For free?
You know it.
What about me, Jim? I have Bright House.
Yours, too.
That's what I'm talking about.
And me?
You have Bright House?
No.
Sorry to hear that. But have your parents call me.
Okay.
Introducing a new way to get the news. the Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, any place. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to learning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
And we're back on Roadrunner Rundown. Still to come on the program, going to be speaking with our athletic director, Ziggy Siegfried, and also Michaela Paige, Dylana Milobar, going to join us, CSUB Women's Swimming. They had a phenomenal weekend, so we'll talk with them as well as we continue on a jam-packed show. And welcome to the program now, coming off a fantastic victory on Saturday night over Grand Canyon and getting ready for Seattle this weekend, WAC tournament next week, head men's basketball coach Rod Barnes. Coach, good to see you. How you been?
I'm doing great. Getting over a little cold here, but allergies, a little problem, but it's going well.
Hey, congratulations on that win on Saturday. I know it was big. It was just one of those teams that, you know, you guys had never quite gotten by, and then you figured out not only how to win, but how to win pretty handily on Saturday night. Your team played phenomenal.
Well, they did. They played really well, and that's what you want to do this time of the year. And again, like you said, they had caused us problem every game that we've played them since we've both been in the league. So it was a special win for us, homecoming and our 20th win. A lot of good things happened for us on Saturday night, and I think it gives us momentum going into our game against Seattle this week.
And you had so many guys play well, too. I mean, we had a heck of a time figuring out when we were even trying to nominate Player of the Week. Mm-hmm. We're like, do we go with Kevin Mays, 21-10? But Diedrich was so good in 19, and he had 7 assists and 6 rebounds. I mean, and then Damian Durham had 15 points. He hit 5 threes. He hit shots. We need him to hit shots. I mean, you had so many guys that even the role players that came in, Justin Hollins, Matt Smith, everybody seemed to contribute and have really good games.
Well, they are. I mean, this team is starting to really, you know, I mean, I feel like all year long we've had guys that come off the bench, but now I think guys are really figuring it out. I think Matt Smith is as healthy as he's been. I think Justin Holland has figured out what we need for him to do, and Damian has been Damian. You know, it's just the nights that he played well, we just separate, and that's what happened to us the other night. I thought our guys were playing really well, and then he hit a couple of big threes, and you know, it seems like it just gave us a whole lot of confidence.
And on top of that, too, I mean, Ali Ahmed had some foul trouble, so you did a lot of this dominating without Ali. You had Justin Hollins come in and give some good minutes, and then Kevin Mays was just really, once in a while, he gives us that vintage Kevin Mays feel, and that was him, I mean, fighting for rebounds, getting putbacks, and making tough shots down low.
Well, that's the thing about Kevin. I mean, he's lately here down the stretch, you know, he's been really our go-to guy. I mean, a lot of the defense has been really focusing on Ali, but Kev has really, really turned it up, and we go to him a lot down the stretch, and he's been answering the call.
And it was another good example the other night. He hit from shots from the outside. He was down low. We're seeing some of the highlights right now, and very good for your squad. And so you get this win. I mean, and really on the line, there wasn't a ton on the line in the game. Your seed's locked up in the tournament, but you want to play well, as you pointed out. You wanted to be Grand Canyon, yeah. So you were able to do a little bit of both. So really, you didn't have a problem getting your guys, I guess, amped up and ready for this game.
Well, not at all. I mean, that's the thing about this team. You know, they when they get to the floor, I mean, they're ready to play. They're ready to compete. And that's what happened to us on the other night. You know, we talked about 20 wins, which was a goal. We talked about his homecoming. And we talked about defending our home floor. But we also talked about Grand Canyon, that it's been hard for us to get over them. And this is the team and this is the season to kind of break through. And hopefully we continue that. You know, I think, you know, heading into the Seattle game, a lot of people say, well, you still don't have a lot to play for. You see, you know, you got your 20 wins. But this is the kind of team that likes to compete. And I think they'll be ready on Saturday just like there was this past Saturday.
I mean, you know what sounds better than 20 wins is 21.
no question about that. I was telling the coaching staff the other day that, you know, we could end up, this season could keep going and going and going and turn into something that we'll wonder one day, you know, can we ever win that many games again? Because, you know, it's just that type of team that, you know, they're not tired of playing. They're enjoying playing. We're enjoying coaching. And, you know, it's where you want to be, mindset, you know, as far as confidence. Again, we've got to get Kevin a little bit more healthier before next weekend, but it gives us some time this week and some of next week to get him ready. But our team is pretty healthy. You know, we feel pretty good about where we are, and now we just got to go out each night and play well.
Let's talk about the 20 wins real quick, because I know you brought up years ago really talking about a winning season was a goal, and then 20 wins is kind of a marker for a program as well. I mean, for you as a coach, that's an important milestone, isn't it?
Well, it is. I mean, when you start looking at it, first of all, you know, 20 wins, everyone kind of makes that as a mark that, you know, it wasn't a fluke. You didn't just try to get over the hump. I mean, you have to win some games in your non-conference, and you got to win a bunch of games in your conference play, which kind of solidifies that your team is really good. And, you know, also with that, it keeps you kind of in that mark of being under double-digit losses. You know, when you get to 20, it's kind of hard to be like 20-14 or something like that. So, you know, it's just one of those things that coaches kind of put a mark on. If we can get to that, then we kind of realize that our program probably is in pretty good shape overall. And I'm just excited because it was an accomplishment that I've been saying for the last few years that I'd like to accomplish, kind of give us a measuring stick. But our guys actually set that this year. This is what they wanted to do. Now, how they came up with 20, I have no idea. but, you know, they've worked toward it, and it was great the other night to tell them after the game they had accomplished their goals. And, you know, we've got to, you know, one huge one left that hopefully we can say that we'll accomplish it in a couple of weeks.
And you got to Seattle coming up on Saturday. You know, you're looking for 21 wins, and you're also sending a couple seniors off, and Kevin Mays and Ali Ahmed, guys that have really been Ali for the last three seasons, Kevin for the last two, a big part of your program, and kind of helped you sort of build your identity a little bit.
Well, they have. I mean, both guys are pretty rough, tough kids that are, you know, if you look at their careers and since they've been here, that they every night they've gone out, you know, and it kind of gives us some stability on the front line. And we've been able to go to them, for Ali for the last 3 years and now Kevin for the last 2 years, and they've logged great minutes together. They've built a great relationship. They live together. So, you know, it's been a fun deal. It's going to be really, you know, a sad day in some ways on Saturday to send those guys off as far as senior night, but also one that's rewarding to see both guys, how much they've grown, what they've done for our program, how they've helped us recruit. It's just been two guys that we'll always be able to say helped us at, you know, being in a Division I program, really kind of cemented us as a Division I program and kind of set us on solid footing. So we're definitely thankful for them. And, man, we can't wait until you know, Saturday night. Again, it'll be a bittersweet deal. Exciting for to get there, but also, you know, I told them I'm going to make some kind of appeal that they get another year of eligibility. So, but it's been fun.
And, you know, it's funny you bring up the fact that these are two kind of rough and tough guys, but I tried to get them on the show today because I'm thinking about senior day. We'll talk about it. And JD, the director of ops, said they can't make it. They have art class together at 10 o'clock on Tuesdays. So Ali builds stuff for his cats.
Yeah.
He builds his elaborate cat houses, and Kevin is building some kind of wooden tricycle or something.
Right. So. Well, the thing is about those guys, man, as tough as they are, as hard as they play and the way they compete, man, off the court, both of them are just great young men
yeah.
and gentle guys, and it's good. It's one of those things that as a coach, it's kind of a coach's dream, you know, where you can hang out with a guy and talk with him and enjoy being around him. And then when they get on the floor, it's almost like they start to really compete and play hard and do what you ask them to do. Always, you know, sound and how you're coaching them and how they're receiving coaching. So easy guys to coach and been fun. It's been a great run with them.
And, you know, you look forward here a little bit, and you're seeing, we've talked about this throughout the year, but you want everybody to sort of be playing well and contributing when you get towards the postseason because that's what makes a difference.
Right.
And you're seeing where it used to be, you know, the scouting report against Bakersfield was stop Mays, stop Ahmed, and you're going to win a game.
Yep.
That's not the case anymore because now you've got Dedrick Basil, Jalen Arrington, Damian Durham,
right.
and everybody coming off the bench. I mean, do you kind of feel right now that your team is probably the hardest to defend that they've ever been?
Oh, no question about that. I mean, because not only that, I mean, even when those guys, when you think about it, even when we may have a guy didn't have a great game, they're still contributing, whether that's assist or – you know, they do a really good job of, you know, keeping our offense going. So, or they're, you know, like the other night, Ali didn't play a whole lot, but when he played, their other team's defense was so focused on him. Mm-hmm. And I just still, I keep telling our guys, you know, we played the other night and we won. And I mean, people, and the guys keep looking at me like I'm crazy because I keep saying, man, we beat them. And Ali played 18 minutes and Jalen Arrington didn't have a good game. And Brent Rapp went 1-for-8. And, you know, I kept going on and on. And they go, and I said, you guys figuring out what I'm trying to say? I'm trying to say that we still haven't peaked.
Right.
And that's what we want to do. So I told them, we've got to get these things straight this week and be prepared for next week. Because if we can peak at the right time, we're playing well and we're in a good place. But if we could peak at the right time, I told them special things that happen for this team. And we're expecting that. We're anticipating that. To, you know, the next couple of weeks to be a great week for our program and for our team. And, you know, it's exciting. And again, whenever you have the kind of confidence that our guys have, you feel good as a coach going into the last couple of weeks of the season.
Let's talk real quick. Seattle on Saturday, a team that you handled up at their place. They've had a couple decent wins since, a couple winning streaks since. You know, they've got some good guard play and a decent post. So how do you sort of prepare against them on this Saturday night?
Well, it's going to be kind of the same. I mean, obviously, you know, they come in and the point guard is really playing well, shooting the basketball, making a lot of big shots, and we're going to have to really defend him. And then their post player, I mean, Big Crook and Powell, the two really sound guys, kind of like Ali and Kevin as far as being – you know, really stability in their front line. And we're going to have to make sure we're aware of it. And obviously, they're going to come here, one, to spoil senior night. They're probably going to want to come in because we beat them pretty good at their place. So it should be, you know, a really good game and should be a test for us again. And again, it's good because it's a good team that we're playing. That's what I said about Grand Canyon. You want to play a good team at the end of the year and you want to win because you got to play well. But also you gain confidence and playing a good team. So this is a very good team that will be coming to our place. So hopefully we can close out with a great win and then head over to Vegas and look forward to the tournament.
All right, sounds good. Coach, congrats again on the good winning going on so far in this streak. And we'll talk to you. We'll see you again on Sunday or Saturday.
Thank you.
All right, head coach Rod Barnes here on Roadrunner Rundown. When we come back, Ziggy Siegfried will join us. Back with more. This is Roadrunner Rundown.
It's a look, a style, a way of life. Wherever you go, everything about it says luxury. And from the moment you sit behind the wheel, you'll just know it never looked back. At Mercedes-Benz of Bakersfield, you can now lease a 2016 C-Class sedan for only $399 per month. So wherever the road of life may take you, make sure it's in a Mercedes-Benz.
Test drive one today at Mercedes-Benz of Bakersfield and the Bakersfield Auto Mall.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to winning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, any place. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
Introducing TBC Mobile from the Bakersfield, California. The most complete news, sports, weather, video, opinion, and lifestyle coverage in Bakersfield and Kern County. It's the easiest way to stay up to date on all things local while on the go. Read it on your smartphone or tablet. Download now by searching Bakersfield, California in the Apple, Google, and Amazon app stores.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. Still to come on the program, Michaela Paige, Dylana Milobar are going to join us. CSUB Women's Swimming. They had a championships and record smashing this past weekend at the WAC Championships in Houston. So we'll talk about that. Before we go any further, before we bring Ziggy on the program, I want to correct myself from the very first segment. My good friend Janice Varner pointing out that we had Reuben Franklin listed at 187 instead of 197. 197-pound Reuben Franklin. There you go. Thank you, Janice. Thank you, Ruben. Thank you, Ziggy, for bringing it to my attention. Ziggy Siegfried joining us on the program. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, absolutely. And a shout out to the wrestling program who what a year that they had. Yeah. Ruben, Bryce winning the Pac-12 championship.
Again, third time.
I know. And they're not done yet.
No.
So New York, here we come.
And I saw Ruben the other day, and Ruben had a tough championship match, which was just, it happens in wrestling. Sometimes you try something and you get caught and you get stuck. But I saw him yesterday and I thought, I see him kind of walking towards me and I'm thinking, oh, he's going to be kind of angry, you know, and he kind of, and then he smiles at me and said, hey, Corey, how you doing? I was like, oh, hey, Ruben. I said, how are you? He goes, oh, I'm great. So obviously he's ready for nationals. So,
oh yeah, he will be.
He'll get in. They'll announce that next week. So we'll have four wrestlers in the nationals in New York, which will be awesome. And then just to continue on, really, what an awesome weekend it was, jammed up with everybody involved. But I wanted to talk about men's basketball real quick. I mean, we had Coach Barnes in the last segment, but hitting 20 wins, having another big crowd on Saturday night. I mean, that was kind of a cool night all around.
It was, and it just feels so good to look up and see the stands packed and to have so many people there and know behind the scenes how much work went in with our staff and how excited people are about the type of program that has been built by Coach Barnes. It's just fantastic, and to win is just icing on the cake.
Yeah, and it was a homecoming night, and to have the alumni back and to see what's kind of happened and see what's been built and see the kind of basketball we played, it was really cool, and it was a good night all around. And then, you know, baseball's off to a good start at 4-2, taking their first two series. It took Sunday, and that's what I like about this team, because it's a lot of the holdovers from last year's championship team chips are down. They're finding a way to win. I mean, Sunday wasn't great. We didn't hit the ball well. We had a winning run in scoring position four times in a row. Mm-hmm. We couldn't get it across, much like Friday. But we just kind of got the right people in the right situation. David Metzger delivers, and you know, the team pitched well enough, that, and they beat the defending Big East champions 2 out of 3.
Yeah, that's what's exciting. You know, you start off with a series win last weekend against Northridge, team that won 30-plus games. Yeah. Then you come back and you win the series against Big East champs, and you said it, you know, find a way. That's their slogan.
Right.
They always find a way to win the games, and they're a fun team to watch.
Yeah, and it was a great weekend for them. A big win on Saturday. Local product Andrew Hansen just dominating and throwing a great game, throwing a gem. He had the guy goes 7 innings, he throws 65 pitches. Like, you don't see that kind of number. That's like the model of efficiency. So that was a great win as well. And so we're kind of off to a good start in the spring, but we're wrapping the winter. We're getting to a really exciting time. And, you know, both basketball teams are playing well right now. Women's basketball is right there in the hunt for, you know, potential up to a 2 seed still. It's kind of crazy as we get ready for Las Vegas how well the basketball teams are playing and how realistic, you know, championships are.
Yeah, they are. And I told the women's basketball team at the beginning of the year, I have my suit picked out for when we go to the NCAA tournament. And it looks like they have a good shot at a 3 seed.
Yeah.
And like you said, could sneak up even higher. Men's basketball, I mean, what a magical season. Best in Division I history. And right now, our guys just look loose. They look, let's just keep on playing. Let's keep on having fun. And our other programs are doing well. Water polo right now had a sweep this weekend. Wrestling, top 25 program. You know, at least 4 going to the NCAA Nationals. We could maybe have 5, a fifth one sneak in there. So it's just a good time. And then obviously, you know, our swim team, who will be coming in here shortly, and they, you know, our women's swimming and diving had a fantastic, WAC championship.
Yeah. And that's kind of why we're going to bring, you know, Michaela and Dylana into the program today as well. I know I was calling, Michaela's effort is kind of it's the Kurt Schilling bloody sock, version of, CSUB athletics. I mean, she basically swims with one arm, to win a couple titles for CSUB. So that's very cool. So, you know, wrapping the winter, let's look forward to Vegas a little bit real quick. You've got a couple, like we said, the men's basketball team, a 2, women possibly 2, 3, 4, right around there. But we're kind of the buzz for what could happen in Las Vegas this year is probably greatest that it's ever been because of the way the teams are playing.
Yeah, and one thing I'll say is we need our fans. We need Bakersfield to be there. Yeah. So now's the time to go ahead and buy those tickets, make your plans. You can call 654-BLUE to purchase the all-session tickets. We have a great chance to cut down the nets this year. And we want everyone to be there to experience it. I know the Bakersfield Californian is going to be there in full force. So be in Vegas. Why wouldn't you be?
Well, yeah, it's Las Vegas. It's 4 hours away from here. 3.5 if you drive really fast, which is totally possible on I-15. And if people go to Vegas anyway, choose this weekend or next weekend, actually, and make it. Because the college basketball action from the WAC, the Mountain West, the Pac-12, I mean, everybody's in Vegas at the same time. It's a huge college basketball environment, so we encourage people to come on out. So that's happening. Basketball is in what really could be a historic run right now. And then the spring season is starting up, and we've talked about the start for a couple of those teams, but really we're looking at a bright spring the way that things have kind of started with water polo. Softball had a rough weekend this past weekend, but they started out with a good weekend the weekend before. So really the spring looks like these, again, teams could kind of pick up where they left off last year.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be the case. Like you said, with baseball, looks really good. Softball is going to always continue to build as their pitchers kind of find their way a little bit. And I think it's going to be – I think you're going to find every year we're just going to keep on getting better.
Yeah. And beach volleyball opens up this weekend as well. They'll be opening up too. They have a home duel at – I'm trying to pull up the time here real quick. But beach volleyball will be opening up as well, and that's going to be their first season as a conference member. They'll be an affiliate member of the Big West, but they're going to start Thursday at Northridge, and then Saturday they're hosting an exhibition, MiraCosta College at 2, and then again Saturday Concordia at Irvine at 4 o'clock at the beach volleyball complex on Saturday afternoon. So a couple chances for people to check that sport out. And, again, that was a team that was – pretty good last year, and again, bringing back some important players.
Absolutely. They're fun to watch, and I encourage everyone to come out to the Barnes Beach Volleyball Complex there on campus.
Yeah, they'll be home the 5th, the 11th, and the 19th as well. So a lot of beach volleyball action to come as well for the runners. And you brought up really the program sort of building and getting better. I mean, the coaches, it seems like, have finally got to a point where they're starting to put their stamps on their programs. I mean, Coach Barnes, being here for 5 years now, has all his athletes. Coach McCall has his players. And you go to even what Bob Macaluso's doing, what he's brought in and what he's recruited his first year of baseball. And we're seeing these coaches that have been around in the program for a few years getting their touch on the program. That seemed to help all the teams in general.
Yeah. You know, I think all of our programs continually focus on – you know, almost overachieving. Mm-hmm. We always expect to win, no matter how we start the season, no matter how we're doing in the middle of the season. Our expectation is to be playing for championships, and it's just fun. We have a good, really good group of coaches and staff.
Yeah, and so far, like we've seen, a good spring to get going, and you know, we go back to baseball real quick, but they'll be on the road at a tournament in Arizona this weekend. But Bob Macaluso in his first year seems to be having a great time so far. The players seem to be really latching onto him as a new head coach. I know it's hard for him as a guy replacing somebody who built the program, but he seems to be right at home, and the players are responding.
They are. Coach Macaluso is doing a fantastic job. I just look out there when he's walking to change pitchers. I'm like, who's he going to pick? And then all of a sudden Malik comes in and Chance and
Coach. That was the best substitution the other day. You want to talk about Little League Baseball. He walks out to the mound. There's nobody in the bullpen. So I'm thinking, who's he going to? There's nobody in the pen. Veilwald runs off the field, gets a different glove, goes from first to second. Malik runs in from shortstop, gets a different glove. He comes in to pitch. So, Grotjohn goes over to third base. Joey Sanchez runs into – it was a Little League shift, and Malik Jones, who never pitched his entire life, comes in and throws a shutout inning and strikes a guy out.
It's unbelievable. Everyone has to be ready to play.
It was great. I mean, and everybody must have like four gloves in their bag because everybody can play eight different positions. Yeah. And it was an awesome Little League shift the other day that he – that he pulled in, and here's Malik comes in and never pitched before in high school or college and throws good stuff and gets a shutout inning and a strikeout. It was awesome, but it seems like he's really taken to this team, and the team is taken. I like watching Bob in infield because he does a lot of the stuff that normally an assistant would as he was, but he coaches third base and he also hits infield. Watch Coach Mac at the end of infield. His big pride moment is when he hits the ball to the catcher. It's hard to do. You ever try to do that, hit the ball to the catcher? Very tough to do, and most coaches they'll flub it. But like Mac will hit one right up the middle, and then he grabs his bat and he sprints off the field, and the team cheers. Yeah. That's his favorite moment of the day.
They love him, and that's the type of coach you want. Yeah. They love their coach
for sure. And good start. They'll play Fresno State tonight. They'll be on the road this weekend at University of Arizona as well. So spring will continue. Las Vegas coming up next week. That'll be big. We're hoping to have some history made in Vegas, Ziggy. And I know you'll be there. I'll be there. And let's make a little history.
Absolutely. Let's get a piece of that net.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I was thumbtacked out on my wall. All right. Thanks so much.
Okay. Thank you, Corey.
All right. When we come back, we're going to talk some swimming. Michaela Page, Dylana Milobar will join us. Big weekend for the runners. We'll talk about that next. This is Roadrunner Rundown.
Community. Hello, Bakersfield.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders, from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, anyplace. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to winning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others.
Just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
Welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. My thanks to Ziggy Siegfried for joining us on the program. Our athletics director, head coach Rod Barnes, joining us in segment number one as well. Get the show anytime online at GoRunners.com. You can also watch it Bakersfield On Demand on Bright House Networks. I want to welcome to the program now a pair of CSUB swimmers that had phenomenal championship weekends this past weekend in Houston. Runners had five records, championships as well going on in the WAC tournaments, WAC championship. I want to welcome to the program senior Michaela Paige, champion of the, let's see, 200, just tell the people because I'm going to screw it up.
Individual 200, the 800 free relay, 400 free relay, and 400 IM relay.
That's four, all right? That is four titles. And then junior Dylana Milobar, who had a championship in the?
400 medley relay.
And then you also, don't be proud, you had a record, you shattered a school record in the?
200 breaststroke.
200 breaststroke. And that actually record had held for quite a while. So congratulations to both of you for a, I mean, what was it like? I mean, your team continued each day to get better and break records and win championships. I mean, Michaela, you as a senior, this had to be kind of a pretty special send-off.
It was amazing. We battled for second, third, and fourth place with teams all weekend long. So it was great to see that my team has improved so much over the 4 years.
And then to be a part of those championship relays and you know, what was it like to kind of go out on such a high note and winning these titles?
Bittersweet. it really hasn't hit me yet that I'm done swimming. I'm a little bummed. I'm not really satisfied with how I did, but I'm proud of my team and what we've accomplished.
No, it was great, and it was fun to watch, and kind of we were sort of watching the Saturday night. We were kind of watching the championships courtside during basketball game. But before the game started, we kept walking back and forth, going, "Oh, the 200 final. Oh, here's the relay final." And Dylana, to have an opportunity to win a championship as well as a junior, what was that like to be on a relay team that took home a title?
That was pretty cool because I don't think we've ever had like a medley relay that's even scored past fifth place.
Wow.
So it was neat to actually win because we were like, I hope we get third before we dove in.
Say that before
we were all nervous. Like.
Well, what was the difference in this race? I mean, was it just when everything kind of fell into place and everybody was on or what?
Yeah, I mean, it's been the same people for like the last 3 years doing the medley relays, and honestly, we all just got better.
Yeah.
So.
Nice. And then you break the record as well in the 200 breaststroke. I mean,
yes.
That was something that had stood for quite a while. So what was that experience like to take home a big time school record?
That was satisfying because the last 2 years I've been like half a second off. Like, so by the time I got it, I was like, oh, finally. But
is that frustrating with swimming? Because swimming literally can be, and I guess sports like track, anything timed, but you can be a hundredth of a second or a half a second It's got to drive you nuts, right?
Yeah, it's insane.
To be that, usually the rest of us measure our life in like minutes and seconds, but when it comes down to fractions of seconds, I mean, what's the difference in a fraction of a second? Is just one better stroke, you know, or
yeah,
basically?
Seriously, a fingernail being longer.
There you go. Now, I know, I know Michaela is, she brought up the fact that she's a senior and she's finished, but all I know is there's this legendary story going on now that you basically swam the last two events with one arm for the most part. You've had a shoulder injury. It's been bothering you for a while.
Yeah.
Got better, got worse again. So what happened on that last day? I mean, you're basically, from what I hear, in tears. You're the pain's so bad. You refuse to be. Chris Hansen wanted to pull you out. You're like, no way.
Yeah.
So what all went down with that shoulder on the last day?
Yeah, well, for prelims, my 200 fly, I didn't do very well. But I talked to my dad a lot over the phone in between, and it was just, it was my last race, you know, this is the last time you're ever going to swim. So I just kind of just gave it my all and said, you know what, like, I'm just going to go for it. And I did cry after my 200 final, but I mean, that 100, the 400 relay, I knew that we were going to win that, and I wanted to be a part of that and just finish my career with my best friends winning a title. So
yeah,
that was pretty much it.
1 to 10 on the pain scale, like doctors ask you, where was it at after the race was over?
After the two fly, like an 8.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so, and like I said, they wanted to pull you out. Like, how'd that conversation go? The G-rated version of that conversation. What was the G-rated version of that conversation?
Chris and I have a great relationship, so it was just kind of like, are you sure you're okay? Yeah, I'm fine. You don't look okay. No, I'm doing it. I don't really care. And he's like, okay.
There you go. Well, sometimes as a coach, it's best to just to let him go. Now, I mean, Dylana, you're kind of involved in this a little bit as well. So what were you kind of seeing going, yeah, she's kind of hurt?
Yeah, well, we were rooming together, and every night she would leave and go get this massive bag of ice from the machine, and she'd be, like, taking ibuprofen, and, like, she's one tough girl. Like, and you wouldn't,
you.
She, like, would never complain in front of people. You would never know that she was injured because she did everything to, like, hide it.
Yeah. See, I'm the opposite. I'm going to be walking around going, ah, my arm's killing me. I can't do anything today. Well, no, congratulations. That's a really cool story. And I know you're finished now, so you're sad. But
I'm really sad. I'm real, real sad.
But this will kind of help, I mean, life lessons down the road. I mean, you obviously take a lot away from swimming that you can apply to life moving forward. And what does life moving forward kind of hold for you now?
I truthfully don't know. I guess just, I'm just going to go with it. I mean, I have more free time to do what I want and actually have a life.
Sure.
You know, I'll have some great hair that's not dead.
Right.
I'm traveling this summer, so that's exciting.
Nice. Where are you going?
Europe.
Okay.
So, yeah.
You're doing the whole backpack through Europe thing after I graduate college?
Yes, I
nice.
Am.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
Yeah.
No, I know a lot of people always talk about that, but I'm glad you get a chance to do it. That's
I'm
awesome.
I'm excited. Yeah.
Cool.
So I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what's next for me.
Awesome. And Dylana, you actually are going to be in the Canadian Olympic trials, correct?
Yes.
So congratulations on that. That's coming up when?
April 5th to 10th.
Awesome. What events are you going to be swimming in?
I'm just going to be swimming the 100. So
okay.
Short nice. Meet. Yeah.
No, I mean, and you know, you qualify for that earlier in the year. So have you kind of been preparing for that as you prepare for everything else going on with the WAC and things like that?
Yeah, I mean, I've definitely, like, preparing for WAC and stuff like the eating healthier, staying in shape thing.
Right.
I've kind of been more mindful of that because I know I have to get back in shape to keep training for trials. So
okay.
It's probably helped,
yeah.
To be honest.
That's the bright side. You're done, Michaela. You can eat whatever you want.
No, I have to be more careful now.
Why is that? Oh, because you're not swimming
or
as
not
much.
Burning off those calories.
That's right. Let me tell you. Let me tell you. This is what happens when you stop playing and you eat whatever you want. So, yes. Be careful. You're wise. Not so much. I just kind of went crazy. This is what you get. But, no, I'm excited for both of you. I mean, this was a fun season. This team, it's been great to watch what Coach Hansen's done with the women's swim program, and to have great athletes like yourselves come in and win championships and go to the WAC and you know, break records. And, you know, we're getting to a point now where the record books are starting to, we might as well write them in pencil. I mean, you guys are breaking them every single time you go out, and it's definitely fun to watch. So congratulations on a great season. Congratulations on a great career.
Thank you.
It's been fun to watch, and good luck at the Olympic trials, and
Thank
we'll be
you.
Pulling for you.
Thanks.
All right. Well, we're that's it for us, folks. We're out of here. We can get the show anytime online at GoRunners.com. You can also check us out on Bright House Network's Bakersfield On Demand as well. And don't forget men's basketball at home this Saturday night. Runners hosting Seattle. WAC tournament coming up next week in Las Vegas. That's going to be the 10th through the 13th at the Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. Women's will start on the 9th, actually, and then the men will pick up on the 10th. Tickets are still available, 654-BLUE for your all-session passes, and Runners get a chance to make some history. We'll have great coverage as well on Bakersfield.com through our Roadrunner Rundown sort of special edition programs from the Orleans and Las Vegas, pre- and post-game coverage on Thursday, and then some post-game stuff going on Friday, and hopefully we'll have some post-Saturday night championship stuff happening as well. That's the big hope, and you can catch that more details online at Bakersfield.com. Get our show here on demand at GoRunners.com as well. Don't forget, follow us on Facebook at Facebook.com/CSUB Roadrunners, on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat at CSUB Athletics. Next week on the program, we'll be in studio, and we'll have a big preview of the WAC basketball tournament. We'll have head coach Rod Barnes, the men's basketball program, head coach Greg McCall from CSUB women's basketball, some of the student-athletes as well, as we preview a big weekend in Las Vegas for the basketball programs. And don't forget, we'll have highlights and everything from around all the other sports, including CSUB baseball. We'll also have the bracket will be set for not only the conference tournament, but also with the NCAA Nationals for wrestling. That'll be coming out next week as well, so we'll have coverage of that on the program too. So we will catch you then. Thanks so much for joining us. This has been Roadrunner Rundown.